Master the beat. Stressing compound words in English. Hello, learners. Welcome to another exciting lesson in English pronunciation. Today, we are going to talk about an incredibly important aspect of English speech, the pronunciation of compound words. Compound words can sometimes trip us up because their pronunciation isn't always straightforward. But don't worry, we're here to help. Let's dive in. First things first, let's refresh our memories about what compound words are. Compound words are words that are formed by combining two or more words together. Examples include butterfly, sunflower, airplane, and moonlight. Now, when it comes to pronouncing these compound words, one part of the word usually gets more emphasis or stress than the other parts. This is the basic rule we need to understand about compound words. Here's the key point to remember. In English, compound words are typically stressed on the first syllable. For example, in the word butterfly, we stress the first part, butter, and not the second part, fly. This is the most common pattern you'll see in English. Of course, like all things in English, there are exceptions. But generally, stressing the first part of a compound word will help you sound more natural and fluent when you speak English. Now, let's put this rule into practice. Let's take a few examples. 1. Airplane. Here, we stress air and not plane. 2. Moonlight. We stress moon over light. 3. Firefly, fire, gets the stress, not fly. Practice these words and notice how stressing the first part changes the way the word sounds. Repetition is the key to mastering pronunciation. So, take some time every day to practice saying compound words with a stress on the first syllable. You can even create your own list of compound words for practice. Also, while listening to English speech, pay attention to how native speakers pronounce compound words. You'll notice the stress patterns we discussed today. We hope this lesson has been helpful for you in understanding the pronunciation rules for compound words in English. Remember, pronunciation is about pattern recognition and practice. Keep practicing, and you'll be a master of English stress in no time. Until next time, happy learning. Remember to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon so you don't miss our future videos on mastering English pronunciation. And as always, leave any questions or thoughts you have in the comments below, and we'll do our best to respond.